Alrighty, so for this little video, we're going to talk about something that's very, very much connected to annual percentage yield, or EAR, whichever you want to call it. That's the idea of inflation. And in inflation, we've talked about some different things in class, but inflation is the idea of how much more expensive things are compared to some time ago. It's the idea in a percentage format, or percentage-wise. And that percentage is calculated annually. That is once a year. Okay, so that's kind of a big deal. So one that's a classic is always the, "Well, by George, when I was a kid, 1982, good for you, I remember these days, candy bar was 20 cents." Oh, cool. I can get into that. But the other day, by George, Sonny, it was, this is 2016 now. And sometime later, geez, 20, 30, 34 years later, they're like 85 cents a piece. Back in my day, Now, what a person could do is you could literally count it off. I mean, you could have said 1983, 1984, and so on, and drag it down to 2016, which is down here somewhere. A person could do this the hard way. I don't feel like it, but I'm going to kind of dink around it for a minute, just kind of show you what I mean by this. Okay, and so what a person could do is they could come up here and twink around and say, "Well, I feel like you could put in 5%." And then you could say, "Well, this would be equals the previous amount times parentheses 1 plus that interest rate." Again, just one time per year. Yes, just do what I tell you to, you stupid machine. And then drag it down and see if you get 85 cents. Ooh, well, let's try that again. Oh dear. Okay, there's part of your problem. We did not label this interest or something. So I'm going to call it interest. I'm going to spell it with two T's this time because I'm on the second sheet, I think. And let's see if I can make it work this time. So equals, instead of G1, big dope, you could put interest. There we go. I bet it works this time. Hey, what do you know? Uh-oh. 5%'s a little extreme. And I know that because it would be $1.05 now. And in fact, it's going to be somewhere, it's only 80, what did I say, 85 or 86 cents, and 85 cents, I guess. So, that's too much. It's not quite 5%. And a person could if they wanted to, if you were really bored. I'm so bored. And or you're at your in-law's house. You're like, "Ah, I really wish I could come in and hang out with you guys and listen to your brother-in-law expound on some topic. God knows what he's yammering about. But I have homework to do." And then you go in the other room and lock yourself in there and just dink around on Excel. If you had nothing better to do, hey, that'd work pretty good. Notice how it's about 4.5%, all right? We're just a little over still. A person could dink around again. Let's go one more, I think, and then I'm going to call it a day. Oh! Hot dang, look at that. It's almost perfect, friends. It's almost perfect. And so it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 4.4% interest per year that candy bar has gone up with on average. Now, there is a better way, okay? Because that's ridiculous. Because I'm trying to find a rate. If I knew a rate and I wanted to know what it was worth now or what it will be worth in the future, then it would totally make sense to do it with the dragging method like that. But when it comes to, I have no idea what the rate is. No, it's just way easier to use the formula. So that was 34 years, we said. So they're one time per year. There's no payment. The present value is, what do we say, 20 cents. You can click on it if you like. I'm just going to type it in. And then negative 0.85. And lo and behold, we get, oh, look, it's 4%. It's not 4%, add some decimals. It's 4.34, basically 4.35% interest. Hey, that's pretty darn close. Nice. And in fact, if this amount had been up here in this line, this would have come out exactly 85 cents rather. Okay, you know, a similar deal was the cost of tuition might have used to been, you know, these people that are, oh, it's terrible, the cost of tuition. Well, you know, I'm not going to argue with you. It's not cheap. I have a kid in college. I understand this stuff's expensive. Say it used to be $20 a credit, now it's $300 a credit. I don't know. I'm just making this stuff up. And let's say this was in 1970. I always like people to bring out stuff from, well, 50 years ago. Well, that's not 50 yet, friends. It was a long time ago. It's not 50 years for a few more years. I know. To today, I don't know. Made that up. I feel like that's 46 years, so that's cool. So I could just do equals rate. Again, I can do it this way, or I could click on the drop-down menu. This is how you do it if it's in Google Sheets, because oh, shut up! No one asked you. Because it does. What are you doing? It doesn't have the functionality of drop-downs, so it's kind of sad, but it is what it is. Always zero. And then again, you can click on this guy, comma, and then negative, and click on this guy. If one of them's negative and one of them's positive, it will work out. If you want a positive number, you want to do it the way I did it for you. So, okay, it's 6 point whatever percent. If you'd have done it this way, rate parentheses 46 years, comma, zero, comma, negative, comma, that, it's the same answer. Oops. Usually it comes out negative. Not really sure why it didn't come out negative. That's creepy. Well, there you go. Learn something new every day. And so apparently the computer doesn't mind me when I do that. Here's what happens if you don't, though. And this is the part that I was going to really consider. One of them has to be negative. If it's not, you run into an issue because the way the program is set up, it's looking for one of them has to be negative, one of them has to be positive. If you put them both in as positives, which of course is Latin for hey dum dum, you try to do it right next time. Okay, so just be aware of that. It's kind of an easy deal there. Like, oh my gosh, from $20 a credit to $300 a credit, that's 6% interest over that much time. Oh, that's a lot. I don't know, what was the cost of gasoline in 1970? 1970 Oregon. I don't know. Let's find out. Oh, look at that. Gas was 39 cents a gallon. Let's plug that dog in right there. 0.39. And today, I was outside earlier today, and it was 2.48 where I live, and so gas has gone up about 4.1% on average that whole time. Clearly, it matters when you look at it. About 4 years ago, price of gas over $4 a gallon. So if you'd have looked at it from, let's say, 4 or 5 years prior to that, man, it was going up 30, 20% a year or something ridiculous on average, and it was ridiculous. If you look at it from then till now, it's actually gone down in price on average, let's say 15 or whatever percent per year. And so we could actually do that. So if 4 years ago, so 2012, oops, let's don't do it right there. Let's do that here somewhere. 2012, price of gas was, I'm just going to put 4 and a quarter to remember it being about that much. And so now, 2.48 or whatever today is, I forgot what I said. Not important. You can do the rate business for this as well. And what you'll find is that in 4 years, zero payments, present value was that, comma, negative. One of them's got to be negative, one of them's got to be positive. And you'll see that in fact it's come down 13%, basically 12.5% per year. Again, on average. Right. One of my favorite ones of all time was when in 1946, I still remember that, Grandpa told me he sold all of his wheat that year. Sold it for $3 a bushel. Right. And when I was farming in the 90s, about 94. Price of wheat was about 3.5. You're like, wow, it's really gonna. It no, that's bad. That's sad. So it would be a teeny tiny decimal amount that wheat's gone up in price, and in fact, it's actually gone down if you talk about it in terms of what it's actually worth, right? So number of years was 48. and no payment, and that fella, comma, this one. And of course, it's like 0%. Well, how about that? You need to add. So it's gone up about a third of a percent per year, or 0.003 per year it's gone up, which is terrible. However, he also told me he went out and bought that year a brand new combine, new tractor, and a new truck, $9,000 cash. Cash. Now, in the 90s then, I'm just going to say 3,000 of that went to the combine, I don't know. The combine in the 90s, they were right around $200,000. Getting another zero there. And so if you think about it, so the value of the wheat went up a skosh, okay, in terms of just dollar amounts. But in terms of what it's actually doing, in terms of what the combine was valued at, we need to look at it from this point of view. So it's, you know, equals rate. Again, that was 48 years, no payments, and present value, comma, negative the future value. Boom. So the combines went up in price about 9% a year. Okay. Which is pretty good if you think about it. I mean, 10% a year would have been, you know, like they would have added $300 and then $330. I mean, it's going up pretty fast at first. And then it starts really going up fast later on. Okay. So it's kind of a big deal. Kind of an interesting way to do it there. Yeah. So that is the idea of inflation in terms of how things go up in price. But what happens to my money? Okay, well, if my money, if we have a 3% inflation, which we don't right now, but let's just say we did, 3%. If it's inflation, my money's actually going down in value. Okay, so you can do it a couple of ways. You could still think about it as positive and then just do a subtraction over here. But if it was 3%, that means my money is only worth 1 minus 0.03. Okay, in other words, 0.97. My money's only worth 97% next year of what it was worth this year. Okay, so it's gone down in value. So a person could, if you knew that, you could just say, well, here's my initial amount. And again, you did every amount you like. It's just like 100 because it just comes out so pretty. But 1 minus. Now, it's important that it's minus if you keep this positive. So, okay, I like that. I didn't name an interest, so that's going to be a problem in about 2 seconds. Okay. But, and again, inflation is 1 time per year. So that's important to remember that. So only divide by 1. All right, let's try this again. See if I can do it right this time. At least I caught myself that time, right? Right. Whee! Okay. So 3% interest, if this was now 2016. Oops, stop it. Oop, what am I doing? 2016, 2017, 2018. You will see that in the year 2036, my $100 is only worth $54. That's true. Or another way of saying that, and most of the time it is said this way, is if you had a dollar, that dollar would only be worth 54 cents of what it's worth now. Okay? So, another way of looking at that would be to say, well, you know, if you knew what something would buy back then to what it'll buy now, what would it be? So, for instance, if this was in fact $1980, okay, and then I take and drag those forward to 2016. A dollar from 1980, I mean, our dollar today will only buy a third of what a 1980 dollar would buy. Okay? That is why when we say the prices of everything goes up, in fact, our amount of money we have goes down. Even though I make more today than I used to make, everything else has gone up in price as well. Okay? Remember, it's always relative that way. So just keep that in mind. It technically speaking, if inflation was 2% a year, okay, if inflation's 2% a year and you're not even getting a 2% increase in pay this year, you're going to be losing money. Sort of. Okay. Now, it's beyond the scope of this class, but the way they measure inflation, they put a lot of emphasis on things that a lot of us don't do. For instance, just like some things like cars, things, other stuff that we don't always go out and buy a ton of, right? Gasoline figures more into some of our budgets than others of our budgets. New clothes, a lot of people don't. I personally don't really spend a ton of money on clothes at all. But other people do, but it's part of what they figure the inflation on. Different kind of food figures into that. So if you're a person who like eats out all the time and always has the nicest, newest clothes, you're going to be paying more than 2% interest. If 2% was the average, you're going to be paying more than that. If you're a person who's kind of, doesn't spend a lot, drives a little car, doesn't ever buy a new car, like me, I never buy a new car. I spend maybe more, a little more on gas than some people. I do a lot more driving maybe than some people do. And my car is not the most fuel efficient, but that's how I choose to spend my money. But be aware of that. So it's a little bit of a weird deal in terms of how inflation works. Something you want to read about maybe is the Consumer Price Index. Again, it's beyond the scope of this class. Consumer Price Index. But it does have to do with what we were talking about. So I mentioned it. It's, further reading. It's kind of interesting. But just be aware that when they figure out the price of those goods and then they figure it out again next year and the next year and the next year, they are assuming a lot about the average person, how much they spend on this, that, and the other thing. And if you don't, or you spend more, then obviously you will get dinged hard, less or more hard based on the way the prices have gone up.